In September 2025, Apple released so many UI kits for its different OS, macOS, visionOS, watchOS, all of them have become accessible in Figma. Let's look together at how to use them. Most importantly, how to edit the different components. So we are in Figma. If you're following along with me, start by creating a new design file. Especially now in Figma, there are so many other tools. So you want to start with the design file in order to access the design UI kits. Getting started here, the next step you need is to click on Assets. File shows you what is available to you. Assets takes you to the available libraries. And under the libraries, if you scroll down here to the bottom, you can see all the UI kits that are available. In the past, we've had the Material 3 design UI kit. There's a design system, simple design system from Figma. But now you will see all these extra additional UI kits from Apple. So in order to add a UI kit to your file, select one. Let's start, let's say, with watchOS 26. Once you click on it, it shows you what's available here. And all you have to do is click on Add to File at the very top. This UI kit has become available to me here under Assets. If I click on it, all the components are accessible, as well as the styles, the typography. So let's try doing something like this. If I click on F to create a frame, you can see from the ready-made frames from Figma, there is the Apple Watch series. So this gives you the exact size of a frame. You can see there are examples here. I can drag one and use it. If you're getting started, let's say you're designing a fitness app, you can use these components. This is great. There's a layout grid, which is fantastic because this will help us actually shape how things should be and where you want to place things. Outside the grid, there are process indicators, there are buttons. You can select multiple types, let's say buy with Apple Pay. If I make this fill darker, we'll be able to see all these components more clearly. Now, let's say you want to start designing and you actually want to edit this button. I'm going to double click on it and I'm going to move from Assets to File in order for you to see exactly where we are. The different layers in the left side layer panel. You can see this is the label of this button. Now, I want to edit it. If this is your first time using a UI kit, you will not be able to edit this unless you have downloaded SF Pro as a font. You can see for me right now, it's accessible, but this is a big missing piece that many people are not aware of because it's not directly in the documentation. So in order to edit any of the buttons, it's critical that you download SF Pro. What you have to do is go to the Apple documentation I have linked for you in the description to the Apple design resources, and this is where you find everything that you need, including documentation and resources. So this is the fonts. You can come here and download SF Pro. If you want SF Compact, SF Mono, you can download all of them. If this is your first time, I will guide you. Please keep in mind that currently this is only accessible for Mac users. Maybe the fonts you would be able to access on a PC. But for the next step where you need to edit icons, unfortunately, at this time of recording this video, it's only available for Mac users. I will show this process for a Mac user. If you click on download, you can place this somewhere wherever you need it. If you double click on the fonts or see them in your Finder, you double click on the package, you will have this whole wizard where you agree to the Apple conditions and you can choose whether to install for all users of the computer or elsewhere. And we can do that. If you click on continue, this is an installation type. As you can see, this wizard continues till you're done with this. Of course, you need to enter your credentials. Now, I'm not going to do this because I already have these fonts, but this is the first step that you need to edit any button or any text for the UI kits. I'm going back to the UI kits. And let's add visionOS 26 to our file. Now it's added, you can see from the tag here. So to access it, I will go back to my different UI kits that are available. If you click the back button, you will always go back to the first level. I want the visionOS. There's a beautiful background. There are different controls. This is a new liquid glass that was created by Apple as the main primary style for all their 26 designs. If you would like to see how to use the liquid glass or even how to create it from scratch, I show you this in a different video. I'm linking to this above. Let's say you want to change the icon that you are using here. In order to edit it, let's go back to the file so you can see the different layers. You can see this is an icon here. Now, how do I change this icon? There's different ways to do this. With the camera selected, I need to get an icon from somewhere else. And the best way to do this, if you're on a Mac, is to use the native SF symbol that is available to you through the Apple resources. If we go back to the Apple website right here, if you scroll down or if you go back to the very beginning to resources, you will see under tools, you have access to download SF symbols. So if you click on it and download it, it's an application that following the same wizard process we've seen before, following the steps, you'll be able to install on your Mac and you'll be able to open it. Now, I have downloaded this and it's available to me right here, but for you, you'll be able to search for it or find it in your applications once you've downloaded it. So I'm going to click on SF symbols, and just like it's indicated here, you'll see it has these different icons. So if I select an icon and right click on it, you'll see we have the option to copy a symbol. So I'll click copy symbol and I'm going to do command tab to go back to my Figma. I'm going to click backspace to delete the camera and I will click command V. And now you see my new icon is pasted right here. This is one way of doing it. Let's try one more UI kit. Let's take the iOS and iPadOS 26. I will click on this because I want to get a component, a whole component that's ready. So let's get something like a tab bar. So you can always search for components. So I'm going to get the tab bar for this iPad. The reason I'm showing you this is for components in the right property panel, things are all available right here for you. And you can see the symbols pasted without having to go deeper and double click on them. So for example, I can see the search icon right here as a symbol and I can edit it from the property panel itself. So having selected it, I'm clicking backspace and command V, my icon is pasted right here. This is how you can utilize these incredible UI kits to actually design for iOS for the different platforms that they have created. It's a wonderful addition that designers have been waiting for a while. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more so you can see all this new information as soon as it's released.